Big Bubba Rogers, 380 pounds of Big Bubba Rogers. Tremendous match. $100,000 purse, and this was the biggest house in history of wrestling in Pittsburgh at the Civic Arena. Tremendous match inside of that ring, as well as it is caged in, coached. We can also mention this says a lot and kind of ties in directly with Thunderdome that will be coming up very shortly in Daytona at the Ocean Center, March 15th. Same idea, two men in and one man out.
Absolutely, and of course in this match we are seeing the American Dream, as we stated before, a man who has held the world title three times. He was offered professional contracts in professional football and baseball, a tremendous athlete, and a lot of, you know, one of the top men of all time in wrestling.
No doubt. And there he is, Lex Luger. He has made his entrance back into the state of Florida. Here he is at in Daytona at the Ocean Center. We want to mention Lex is coming back into town, and he is coming back in as an associate with J.J. Dillon. Hi, everyone. I'm Stan Rhodes. Welcome to Southern Professional Wrestling, and along with me once again is Coach John Heath. And Coach, tremendous hour of wrestling excitement. We're going to be seeing the Barbarian, Big Bubba, also the Southern Boys, which right now are the Florida Tag Team Champions. In addition to that, we will be seeing Scott Hall and Stan Lane together, and Lex Luger.
What an hour.
What an hour.
You know, in the world of music, when you speak of the Boss, that's Bruce Springsteen. But he has challengers. People say, well, you know, Willie Nelson's something else too, you know. But in the world of professional wrestling, when you speak of the Boss, there are no challengers there. And of course, I'm referring to the guy that held the world title three times, and our guest over there today, Dusty Rhodes.
Welcome.
Coach, it's great to be back. Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Let me tell you now, right off the bat, Sunday night in Orlando, Florida, Kevin Sullivan, the devil himself, the devil himself, now did and brought Big Bubba to put down my triumphant return to the state of Florida, to hold the multitude, the soothsayers from the street, the magnans from the street, the blacks, the whites, the greens, the yellow, this gathering in Orlando Sunday night for this homecoming, if you will. Devil, you ain't gonna stop the American Dream from coming home.
Well, there you have it, the words from Dusty
Rhodes. That ain't got it, Chad. I'm here at great expense, Jack. Money flowing like wine. Get a close-up of Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. I mean, this is what dreams are made of, baby. This is ticket time on parade, you understand? Kevin Sullivan, you bring Big Bubba down to Orlando Sunday night. You bring him all over the state. And the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, bring him right here in this arena right here. And I'm going to kick his booty, too. Being the boss is meaning you're the boss. I have no equal. The greatest sports attraction in this country is coming home. Go tell your mama. Go tell somebody. Drag them down there. Camp out. Because from here on out, the American Dream is coming back home, baby. It's going to be awesome. Take it, Sam.
All righty. The words from Dusty Rhodes. We're looking forward to that. That challenge from the American Dream. And we've got the Barbarian coming up in just a moment. You stay with us.
Blood-chilling fear, heart-stopping danger. Starcade 86 presents The Night of the Skywalkers. The greatest wrestling video ever. The Road Warriors, Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express. 1,000 pounds of bone-crushing power suspended three stories high. Who wins? Who learns to fly? Who gets the shave? Jimmy Valiant's Big Mama or Paul Jones? Plus, the Andersons and the Rock and Roll Express. The Louisville Street Fight with Big Bubba Rogers and Ronnie Garvin. And the big one, Ric Flair versus Nikita Koloff. The Night of the Skywalkers from Starcade 86.
To order your Starrcade video, get your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-257-1333 or send $34.95 plus $4 shipping and handling to Starrcade 86, Box 8660, Atlanta, Georgia. Sorry, no CODs. Operators are standing by, so call 1-800-257-1333.
Fan. Go, you heard it from Dusty Rhodes. He wants the champion. He wants Ric Flair right here. And I know he's looking forward to that, Coach.
Well, I've always had three champions in the back of my mind. Of course, I've always included Flair. But it's becoming more and more evident that Flair is probably the number one man. And we have a tape of him right now. And
let's
has a few words
him.
On his way to Florida.
Bigger now. The World Heavyweight Champion is back in the state of Florida. Woo, and running wild, driving the women crazy, and beating up any wrestler that thinks he's man enough to walk that aisle and challenge the living legend for this, the World Heavyweight Championship Wrestling Belt, owned and operated by yours truly, Ric Flair, the National Wrestling Alliance, the franchise. You talk about big-time sports, you talk about pro football, you talk about baseball, basketball, you put them all together on one side, then you put wrestling on the other side, and I'll guarantee you, when you want competition, when you want action, when you want quality athletes, then you're talking about the NWA. You're talking about championship wrestling from Florida, and you're talking about the best of them all, Ric Flair, the mechanic, the greatest wrestling technician of them all. Barry Windham, you found out the hard way, punk. Ran you right out of town. Rotundo, you found out the same way. Ran you out of town. Dusty Rhodes, you left because you weren't man enough to challenge for the world title. You weren't man enough to walk that aisle and challenge Ric Flair. That's what it's all about, folks. Competition. You gotta be a great athlete. You gotta be in tremendous condition. You gotta be able to think. You gotta be able to wrestle. Then you gotta be able to walk that walk. In the case of Ric Flair, you gotta be able to wine and dine the lady. You gotta make life right. You gotta live in the biggest house, on the biggest side of town. Gordon Soley, you tell him, when you're talking about Ric Flair, you're talking about the world champion. And let's say one more thing. If it's Rotundo, Scott Hall, Barry Windham, or Dusty Rhodes, the man himself, if you want to find out just where you measure in the greatest sport of them all, if you want to find out where you rank, then you sign that contract. I don't care if it's Miami, Tampa, West Palm Beach, Orlando. I don't care where it is. Ric Flair will be available. He'll have this around his waist, and he'll beat any man that thinks he's man enough to climb in that squared circle and take it from him. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about Ric Flair. Woo, the living legend, the world heavyweight champion, back in the state of Florida, driving the ladies crazy and running wild. Woo.
Well, he is back, Coach, and he is looking for anybody who wants to sign on the dotted line, anybody who has the guts. And right now, in the ring, the Barbarian, being managed by superstar Billy Dundee, tremendous man, doing a little bit of removal of a few cups there that have some metal items that might cause some undue pain. The Barbarian about to take on Black Magic. We've not had a chance to see this man, but a tremendous athlete. He looks already making his way against Black Magic.
Well, Black Magic, 252 pounds of power and muscle himself, is no match out of the standing top wrist lock thrown off by the Barbarian, who again throws off his headlock and then sustains a hard left shoulder block into the midsection of Black Magic, and there following it up with a shot into the midsection again with a foot, only to be an arm drag reverse into the corner. But the power and size of his 22-inch arms of the Barbarian may prove far too much for Black Magic today.
Well, it could be, Coach. The Barbarian perhaps trying to get himself tuned up and warmed up for Jimmy the Valiant, the Boogie Woogie Man. It's going to be tonight in Orlando. Tremendous match between the Barbarian and Jimmy Valiant. Oh, tremendous foot into the face of Black Magic. The Barbarian taking whatever it takes. Superstar Billy Dundee on the outside, giving him instructions, giving him approval.
A running power slam, and that could be it. If he's going to show any mercy, but no. He has more punishment in mind for Black Magic, sending a message out to all future opponents. This is what you can expect. And a flying head drop right into the chest and thorax region, and that is all for anybody, let alone Black Magic.
You're absolutely right, Billy. Dundee holding up the arm of the Barbarian. Tremendous athlete. Did not take a whole lot of time with Black Magic coming up with that top rope, thrusting that head right in to the side of Black Magic. And joining us at ringside, Superstar Billy Dundee.
What's your name? Howdy Doody. I want to tell all you rednecks out there, I don't like rednecks, what my name is. Bill Superstar Dundee. And this is the most awesome force of professional wrestling, Daddy. And Jimmy the Boogie Woody Man just found out how bad he was. And you know why we don't like you, Valiant? Because you're a redneck. You drive around in a pickup truck, and you chew tobacco. And you go into them little bars where the ceiling's low and the smoke, and everybody's wearing either a blackjack shirt or a Harley Davidson shirt. And I don't like them kind of people, and I don't like you. And the reason you got it, Valiant, because I'm the only guy in the world that drove around in the back of EP's limousine, and you went and told everybody in Memphis, Tennessee, that you did it. What you did, punk, was cast in my reputation. Well, Valiant, you just found out what the no-pay grade means. And we're taking you out tonight in Atlanta, punk. And if you don't think we can do it, redneck, just come on down and find out what a man that is.
Well, I'm awfully glad I did not get the left hand of Superstar Billy Dundee. Well, you stay with us. We have got another great match coming up with you, including Kevin Sullivan's got a few words for us, but you'll be seeing Big Bubba in just a moment.
They're off. The lead, the outside. That's my son, Paul, coming up on the inside. Justice's Quest with Oscar Winner. Now, Oscar Winner, Justice's Quest, my copy, Wig Gala. My son Paul on the outside. Then it's Solo Heritage, followed by Reason to Hope and Pat Spratt. At the half-mile pole, a battle. Oscar Winner ahead, Justice and Quest. Wick Gala right there, four wide on the outside. My son Paul. Here they come. Who do you like? Four of them battling now, 3/16 to go. Out on the rail, it's Justice and Quest. Oscar Winner's there. Wick Gala, and on the outside, my son Paul with my copy. 16th to go, the battle's still on. On the outside, my son Paul. Down in the in-between, it's Oscar Winner. And Wig Gala, and on, now down on the rail, it's Justice's Quest, and on the outside, my copy.
Well, lots of folks have been stopping by here, the studios of Southern Professional Wrestling, and once again, the man, the mysterious one, Kevin Sullivan, is here with me.
Oh, no, American Dream. You're not walking back in here so easily. You see, when you left your throne here in the sun, and you took your dream and hopes of your people and left, and they cried and called your name, and you turned your back on them. You see, that is when darkness descended on the throne. And that is when they weep, that is when they cry, and that is when pain, darkness, and agony took the throne to rule. Now you're not just gonna walk in here for a triumphant return, and I'm not gonna advocate this throne. You see, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, the dream is no more. Darkness now rules, and I am king. And Rhodes, to be a king, you have to kill this king. And in Orlando, your home, you see, I am not going to even spoil my hand. I have the biggest and baddest man now that you know. The Louisville Street Fight King. Another king, Dusty Rhodes. And Orlando, the Louisville Street Fight. And the king of the Louisville Street Fight has joined the man that is the king of the sun, because darkness will rule, and it will start tonight again in Orlando.
Well, Coach, there you have the words from Kevin Sullivan. It's talking about how darkness is going to rule. Big Bubba, tremendous man, huge. Whoa! With Lewis Estella, he didn't waste any time delivering a foot.
380 pounds of irresistible force going up against the immovable object, Dusty Rhodes. What a confrontation that would be if you live within 500 miles of Orlando. You want to get to see it. Look at the power. Hey. This guy. Unbelievable.
Tremendous. He has put his foot right out on Lewis Estella. And 1, 2, 3, it is over. Big Bubba.
Big Bubba. The man that is king of the Louisville Street Fight. You see, Rhodes, it's going to end right before it ever starts in your home, Orlando.
Well, challenges for Dusty Rhodes, Kevin Sullivan, the mysterious one, and Big Bubba. We've got a challenge coming up in just a moment with the Southern boys. You stay with us right here on Southern Professional Wrestling. We'll be back in a moment.
Two men enter. One man leaves.
Two men enter. One man leaves.
Two men enter. One man leaves. Thunderdome.
No.
Bayless. I want to tell you about my student, Nancy Leibach, who is deaf and takes dance at the Joffrey Ballet School. She dances by feeling the vibrations of the music from the floor and in the air. She's good enough to have moved from a non-hearing class to a hearing one. Nancy says, ballet is something like a dream, and I love to dream.
Here it comes. Blood-chilling fear. Heart-stopping danger. Starcade 86 presents The Night of the Skywalkers. The greatest wrestling video ever. The Road Warriors, Kim Cornette and the Midnight Express. 1,000 pounds of bone-crushing power suspended three stories high. Who wins? Who learns to fly? Who gets the shade? Jimmy Valiant's Big Mama or Paul Jones? Plus, the Andersons and the Rock and Roll Express. The Louisville Street Fight with Big Bubba Rogers and Ronnie Garvin. And the big one, Ric Flair versus Nikita Koloff. The Night of the Skywalkers from Starcade 86.
To order your Starcade video, get your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-257-1333 or send $34.95 plus $4 shipping and handling to Starcade 86, Box 8660, Atlanta, Georgia. Sorry, no CODs. Operators are standing by, so call 1-800-257-1333.
Well, it seems to be a day that we're welcoming back a lot of great wrestling athletes back into the state of Florida. Brad Armstrong with us, and Brad, I understand you're also a contender for that NWA heavyweight title.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you very much. You know, first of all, I'd like to say it is a pleasure to be back in the state of Florida because, brother, the Sunshine State is one of my favorites, and I'm going to tell you this. You know, there's a lot of people, like you said, you're welcoming a lot of people back and a lot of people coming through. Well, I've had an opportunity as of late, the last couple of months, to travel the world over and to meet some of the top competitors in the world. And that's making me a better wrestler. And what I've got my sights set on is the gold, brother. Ric Flair, the man who's sitting on the top of the heap. He's been toting that world championship belt for about 4 years now, and he's a mighty tough man. But something that I also take into consideration is he's had that belt for 4 years. He takes on the top competitors day in and day out. That can make the man just a little bit road weary. Another thing to look at is he may underestimate Brad Armstrong because he may not be able to sit down and watch the tapes of Brad Armstrong as Brad does of Ric Flair. Because to know your opponent, brother, is to watch the man. And when you know a man's move, you know pretty much where he's going to go the next move. And like I said, he takes on the top competitors day in and day out. I'm a Southern boy. I was Southern born, Southern bred, thoroughbred, born right there in Georgia. And brother, I tell you this, when I get a chance at Ric Flair, you better make the best of it because you know BA is going to. And like I said, Southern style, you're fixing to see one of my brothers, Steve, the Southern boys, get down in the ring right now.
All righty, Brad, glad to have you along with us. He's absolutely right, Coach. His younger brother, Steve Armstrong right now. One half of the Southern Boys with Tracy Smothers going up against the Sterling Brothers. Right now it is Mark Sterling with the boots on up against Tracy Smothers. Kind of interesting. A lot of folks, a lot of great wrestlers going after that NWA World Championship title, Coach.
Immediately action in there, switching headlocks and reversals on hammerlocks and near leg drop scissors by Steve Armstrong, by Steve on my mind, by Tracy Smothers. However, an escape out of there by Mark Sterling, and now an arm stretch and twist being applied and reversed again by Mark, and one reversed once again by Tracy Smothers, whipped over and held in an outside bar. However, Mark Sterling on his feet, only to have here we come with a high fireman carry, also known as the Japanese Wizard, and a drop down and a tag out by Tracy to the other half of the, well, one-fourth of the other famous Armstrong, that was Court speaking right now, of Steve Armstrong. And I remember his dad well, had him in his first match in Marietta, Georgia, many years ago. I win the World Series, performed there beautifully by Steve Armstrong, who now has that outside bar. Mark captured in there, and I'm sure that Mark and Jason Sterling thinking, what an opportunity today, right here on national television, with a possibility of beating the Florida Tag Team Champions, and then looking on down the road, of course, for a possible shot at the World Tag Team title, held by a ravishing Rick Rude and Manny the Raging Bull Fernandez.
Well, you talk about something that needs to be a motivator, and that is definitely right, Coach. Here they have everything to gain. The opportunity to possibly down the road get that chance against the title, to get the title, the Florida Tag Team title, away from Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong, and then somewhere even further down the road, looking for that NWA World Tag Team title. And you mentioned, held right now by ravishing Rick Rude and the Raging Bull Manny Fernandez. Yep. And tremendous action right now in the ring. It is Tracy Smothers with Mark Sterling. And he's tagged out now to Steve Armstrong.
The Florida tag title is such a prestigious title, however, that have no thoughts that Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong have any thoughts whatsoever of giving the Sterling Brothers an equal opportunity to getting their Florida tag title. The Florida tag title probably is the second most prestigious tag title in the entire world today, and they well know it. And on a whip off by Steve, and Mark gets caught by a beautiful flying dropkick by Tracy Smothers, and a double dropkick by the Southern Boys. What a match.
Well, Mark right now reeling from that hit. He caught the bottom end of both Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong's boots, and he is a little bit dizzy making that tag, however, out to Jason. Jason walking in, or having a brick wall run into him. Good moves by both here. A little bit of a standoff. Good move by Jason Sterling, pulling over Tracy Smothers.
Some beautiful moves capped off by a power swing under, executed by Jason Sterling on to Tracy Smothers, who now hurdles Jason. And a reverse whizzer, hip lock run over there, and a kickoff by Tracy. Action almost too fast to follow, and a power wing over by Tracy Smothers, holding Jason Sterling down in there, and an arm deltoid drop, actually, by Steve Armstrong. Arm drag and twist, and power being pursued and pushed off by Steve Armstrong onto good old Jason.
Well, you have that right, Coach. The action is going so quick, and it's kind of calmed down right at the moment, but nonetheless, good move. Good move by Jason Sterling. Well, he quickly tumbled over Steve Armstrong into the rope, split that up, but now Steve has got that left shoulder twisting away.
Line Hesses is finally being countered there by Steve Armstrong, who holds a bar down on Jason, only to suffer the flying weight of Tracy Smothers coming down on it, and a double arm crucifix.
So close.
Off there by Tracy Smothers. Usually a pinning combination, but however, the point of balance by Sterling got him out of that point. A fireman carry whip over by Tracy Smothers. Deltoid drop on there by Steve Armstrong. And Jason had best tag out, or their hopes for ever getting a shot at the Florida Tag Team title may go down in dreams today, because they're up against the top team in the state of Florida right now, the Southern Boys.
Well, they certainly are. Jason right now trying, and he did not. He desperately was trying to get that tag out with his brother Mark, reaching, but only inches away, not able to do so. It is amazing. The Florida Tag Team Champions, the Southern Boys, working so quick, working being so quick together, making those tags. They are just a well-oiled team here. They are going to work so well, even though the looking at that motivation and that ambition by both the Sterling brothers, looking at the possibility of that taking that Florida Tag Team Champion title away somewhere down the road, but it isn't happening right now.
Uh-oh.
Well, wait a moment.
Good spell.
Tremendous
trouble.
Move. Uh-oh.
Whoa, a beautiful reverse roll.
Tremendous. What looked almost to be a pinning combination against the Southern boys turned out to be all it was needed to get the match here for the Southern boys against the Sterling brothers. Tremendous match, tremendous action. That shows why they are the Florida Tag Team Champions. No doubt about that, Coach.
Really good.
Well, we've got coming up in just a moment, you're going to be seeing Mike Rotunda, the All-American. He'll be making an appearance right here in Southern Professional Wrestling in a moment. Stay with us.
2 men enter. 1 man leaves.
2 men enter. 1 man leaves.
2 men enter. 1 man leaves. Thunderdome.
News.
And welcome back. And I should say another welcome back, Coach. This time to Mike Rotunda, an All-American out of Syracuse. And he will be taking on the Golden Boy, Chick Donovan, just momentarily. To be another great match.
Well, Mike Rotunda, you know, while in college, he won the Easterns twice. He was 2 times national AAU champion. As you said before, All-American while at the University of Syracuse. Executes a nice deep fireman carry with outside control against Chick Donovan, the former Southern Heavyweight Wrestling champion. Side headlock put on there by Mike Rotunda. However, any thoughts of throwing Mike Rotunda off an outside headlock by Chick Donovan were quickly garnished. And a nice near leg scissor by Chick Donovan. Only have a back. Mike pull it back out, go up into a hammerlock, and now a strong hammerlock, by the way, because Mike weighs in there about 250 pounds, and he's a very strong, and as you can see, capable not only in the world of amateur. High waist lift there by Mike, float over to the rear, to the left side. No, Donovan, you're not going to get away from this guy.
You know, Coach, excuse me, looking at Mike Rotunda, he's deceivingly quick. Just noticing him moving around with Chick Donovan, very quick, a little bit deceiving to the eye. I'm kind of curious, you had a chance to talk to Mike, and he had some feelings about the Florida title in which he held at one time.
Well, having just watched Mike do some beautiful sit-outs that threw Donovan out of the ring, yes, Mike was telling me that he thought the biggest disgrace ever held as far as titles concerned in the world of professional wrestling was the fact that Sir Oliver Humperdinck held that Florida heavyweight title. And Mike, very upset about the fact, not only about the fact of him holding it, but the way that he also eradicated it by giving it over to Big Ed the Bull Gantner. And Mike is on the trail of Big Ed the Bull Gantner. And as big as strong as Gantner is, I wouldn't want to be in his shoes. As you can see, a man with all the versatility and the wrestling knowledge of Mike Rotunda, he's not the guy to have hunting you down your track.
Well, you're absolutely right about that. I would have to imagine, Coach, that not only does perhaps Mike have his eyes on the Florida title, but maybe even down the road with that open invitation, so to speak, by Ric Flair, who is coming into Florida, wanting to see the ink on the dotted line, that Mike also might be a contender for the world title as well.
Well, there goes Donovan down into a pinning combination, Tony, to escape. Years ago, when I first saw Mike, I said to myself, this guy someday will be a world heavyweight champion. But right now, his thoughts and lust are on that Florida title. And pity either Sir Oliver Humperdinck, if he should ever get him, or Ed Gantner, I pity them, should they ever get caught in that headlock with that hip thrown in and a whip over by Mike Rotunda. As you can see, as I was saying before, it's not just false bragging. When you can do it, it's the truth. And as I have never seen a guy move with such alacrity and so smooth in that ring as Mike Rotunda.
Well, he is moving very strongly now. He has kept Chick Donovan very close to just passing out. Chick receiving another elbow into the head. He was quickly acquainted to the turnbuckle. And Mike going again with another elbow into the forehead of Chick Donovan.
Donovan's thoughts right now, I must be, where's the nearest phone booth? I'd like to dial 911 and get out of here.
Well, he's looking for an emergency help, but he's not getting it. Mike, could he have it? Very close.
Not Nelson with an inside bulldog cradle applied by Mike, but Donovan still has enough supinator rectus strength left in him to kick out of there. How much longer it'll go on, I don't know. It looks like a low blow to me there by Donovan on the Rotunda, which he will pay for very dearly if this match continues much longer.
Well, now it has kind of switched the momentum right now. Whoa, temporarily in for Chick Donovan, and they've been exchanging those slaps and hits into the face. Tremendous right hand. It looked like almost a quick thrust of the right hand into the face of Chick Donovan.
Good night, Chick. You've got the wrong guy excited. And a strong front chancery from the left side employed by Mike Rotunda. As we said before, the former Florida and Southern heavyweight wrestling champion. You know, he held those titles not too long ago. That's in the professional world. And there, a nice waist block and drag down there by Mike Rotunda, and Donovan looking for the escape route.
He has found an escape route. He is backed out of the ring. Perhaps trying to catch his breath. Perhaps trying to shake out some cobwebs. He is back in.
Notice the balance on Rotunda and that quick reflex action to catch that proposal screwed up into the stomach there. One of your great hip wrestlers and control wrestlers of all time is the man you're looking at right now in the black trunks. And I'm referring, of course, to former All-American Mike Rotunda.
Well, he just took a quick elbow into the throat, but he was quick to turn around and get that foot into the abdomen of Chick Donovan. And a couple of reversals there.
Oh, my, there it is. The patented airplane spin, and that fan, take my word, that's all she wrote for Donovan.
You're absolutely right. There it is, and a three count. Mike Rotunda, the result of that airplane spin, has got Chick Donovan permanently grounded for the next few moments. Mike Rotunda.
Well, that was a win for the man who was so upset and felt it was a disgrace that Humperdinck ever had the Florida heavyweight title.
That's
speaking of Humperdinck.
Yeah, it's interesting you brought that up, because the man who's holding the title right now, along with Big Ed the Bull Gander.
My word belongs and everybody knows it. You know, a lot of new faces on the scene now, a lot of old faces coming back. They're calling it the homecoming. I don't particularly like the way this guy Mike Rotunda is talking about me. But anytime he wants to find us, we're not real hard to find. Brad Armstrong on the scene now. You got Dusty Rhodes coming back to the state of Florida. Well, let me tell you something, Daddy-O. Big Ed Gander right here is ready to meet any of them at any time. And I don't care who it is. I don't care if it's Rotunda. I don't care if it's Brad Armstrong. I don't care who you want to bring in. Barry Windham, it doesn't matter to me. Windham, we beat up your kid brother so bad we put him on a shelf for about 6 or 8 weeks. So if you want some of it too, just jump on the bandwagon, brother, because we're going to be ready for it. And now, what everybody I know has been waiting to see today is what we like to refer to as a moment with Big Ed. So if it's ready to go, girls, get ready for it, because the contest is still on. The Dream Day contest with Big Ed. Send the cards and letters in. They're coming in every day in volume. 106 North Albany, Tampa, Florida, 33607 for the Dream Day with the big man right here. And on March 15th, in Daytona at Thunderdome, the lucky lady will be selected. So if we can, Mr. Director, please, let's have a moment with Big Ed.
Well, let's take a look at this. Hear yourself.
BMOC, brother. Big man on campus. When I played football at the University of Central Florida, they knew who the big stud was, the big man on campus. When I walked down the halls, they cleared the way. Whether it's at UCF or the University of Tampa, brother, they know who BMOC is, brother. Big Ed Gander, big man on campus.
Well, big man on campus. More words from Ed the Bull in his Dream Day.
Humperdinck talks real brave. He's going in and say, I'm right behind you, way behind you. When he mentions those guys that Gander may have to face.
Well, here's another contender possibly that Ed the Bull did not mention, and nor did Sir Oliver Humperdinck. And in just a moment, we're going to be seeing Big Scott Hall with Stan Lane in just a moment. And don't forget, we've got a match with Lex Luger coming up in just a few moments as well in Southern Professional Wrestling. So you stay with us. We'll get back to all the action in just a moment.
Bam!
am going to take off to go up to Daytona. I have some more business to do in regards to Thunderdome, and I have asked J.J. Dillon to fill in along with John Heath to help us out, finish out this hour of Southern Professional Wrestling. And J.J., I know we've got a great match coming up. I appreciate you doing this.
Very good, Sam. My pleasure, that's for sure. Coach, it's very good to see you again. This is a very exciting moment for me. Coming into the Sportatorium, this is the place where the greatest names of professional wrestling history have passed through these same doors and into the same ring. It's almost like an unofficial Hall of Fame of professional wrestling. And for me to be able to come back here, you know, it all started with the announcement that slid out with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, making his triumphal homecoming. And a whole chain of events have taken place, and I'm not here by accident.
I understand that.
We have an exciting match in the ring, so let's get to the action.
All right, let's go to the ring right now as we await a match with Stan Lane and Big Scott Hall going up against Tommy Wright and Bob Cook. And
you know, Coach, I mentioned the chain of events. American Dream's been away for a long time, and he enjoyed a status unequaled by any other wrestler in the history of professional wrestling in the state of Florida. And I know it caused a little concern to someone like Kevin Sullivan, who I've had the utmost respect for many years, Big Ed Gantner, a few other people. And so we've sort of shored up the defenses, if you would. It's not by accident that superstar Bill Dundee and the Awesome Barbarian are suddenly on the scene. That you hear names like Nature Boy Ric Flair, world television champion Tully Blanchard, the world tag team champions Ravishing Rick Rude and the Raging Bull. But by the same token, the American Dream has always been the unpredictable one that you could never really figure out what he was doing. And now all of a sudden, people like Scott Hall and Stan Lane, you see some other familiar faces like Barry Windham and Brad Armstrong. And I guess it's all going to explode tomorrow, tonight in Orlando. And I got a feeling it's not going to end suddenly. This is just the beginning of some great things for the future, kind of the tip of the iceberg.
That's the tip of the iceberg. As I listen to those names being mentioned, who will be in action tonight in Orlando at the Eddie Grant Sports Complex. I think these matches start at 8 o'clock, too. It seems like a Hall of Fame in the world of wrestling when you mention off Barry Windham, pardon me, Lex Luger, and Dusty Rhodes, just to mention a few, the Barbarian. Unbelievable. And these fellas right here will be in action, too, as we see a power wing over demonstrated in there by Stan Lane on to Bob Cook, who got it up into a half Nelson or a hammerlock. Cook wisely tagging out to Tommy Wright, only to be caught into a near leg scissor. And Lane, once again, has his opponent very much in control. I thought he might take him up into an ankle ride, but no. He chooses to tag out to his partner, Big Scott Hall.
You know, Coach, another man around here that maybe is going to be showing a little bit of concern is Bad News Allen. And I know he's been looking forward to this Thunderdome where two men go in and only one's going to leave. And I looked at Kevin Sullivan's face this morning and I saw a new look of confidence. And I know what Kevin Sullivan is capable of, and I hope Bad News Allen doesn't get a false sense of security because of names like Dusty Rhodes and Barry Windham, Brad Armstrong and Scott Hall being on the scene at the same time.
I'm sorry. Well, they're speaking of a man who won two gold medals in the Pan Am Games and, of course, came in with a bronze medal in the World Olympics. Bad News Allen, great contender. But as you said before, all the names that are coming and being mentioned, it's almost unbelievable to realize that they are on the Florida scene once again. And here, a double leg pickup and turned into a possible Boston Crab by Stan Lane. He's applying this onto Tommy Wright, and Tommy suffering an awful lot of pain in the lower lumbar region right now. And of course, pain. And here, possible, he might switch over and throw the double ankle ride. And speaking of big names, of course, when you mention Barry Windham, we've got to think about that fellow as one half of the United States tag team title, and the other fellow is Ronnie Hansa Stone Garvin.
That's right. And I guess we better not forget Nikita Koloff, fellow superpower of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. He, too, will be a force to be reckoned with.
Unbelievable. As I said before, it's like a Hall of Fame in the world of wrestling when I hear these names.
You know, Coach, I hear you mention the Eddie Graham Sports Stadium. I get chills when I think of walking back in there. My last appearance in the state of Florida several years ago was a match in which someone that I had a lot of confidence in, if he lost that match, I had to leave the state of Florida. And it was one of the dark points of my career and a very embarrassing moment. And it's going to be with great pride tonight that I can walk back into that same Eddie Graham Sports Stadium with Lex Luger, who is an official associate of the Four Horsemen, because he has taken on a new dimension since leaving the state of Florida, and he's coming back with a new arsenal.
It'll be interesting to see Lex Luger. He'll be appearing right here on the scene in a very few moments, right on this television program. And right now, speaking of world contenders for tag matches and the fellow who fellas who could be going up for the Florida tag title, these two fellows right here, Stan Lane, Big Scott Hall, what a combination they are, JJ. And here we see a key lock style hammerlock being employed by Stan, who relinquishes that, goes into a straight bar hammerlock and tags out to Big Scott Hall. A lot of power demonstrated by the 291-pound Scott Hall, a man. When we speak of Orlando, I believe that is his home. And what a night that will be tonight. You mentioned all those names.
Well, with all due respect to Scott Hall, when you speak of power, I think of only one man, and that's Big Bubba Rogers, who is the ultimate bodyguard. And, you know, Kevin Sullivan and myself and a few other people could very well get the last laugh, because we could see the last of the American Dream tonight when Big Bubba Rogers, and I think we should not lose fact that it is a Louisville street fight, and that's the specialty of Big Bubba Rogers, the ultimate bodyguard, and nobody can do it better than he can.
As I said before, if you're within 300 to 500 mile radius of Orlando, an opportunity tonight to see what I call the Hall of Fame of wrestling when all the stars step in the ring at the Eddie Graham Sports Complex.
Well, I promise you one thing, Coach. The confrontation between the American Dream and Big Bubba Rogers will not be a wrestling match. It's going to be a fight.
Well, reverse arm drag whip to set Bob Cook up for the fact that Stan Lane came in for the front chancery with a hammerlock combination on now, and once again he goes into a high bar hammerlock on Bob Cook, and Bob has been trapped. If Stan decides to go over and float over, as he is doing right now, for a reverse half Nelson, changing that bar lock into a Sullivan bar and reverse Nelson, you could have a pin on your hands right now. A fantastic wrestler, and the wrestling of Mike Rotundo just seems to get better as it goes on and on. I'm sure you don't care to make any favorable comments in that direction, Jay.
Coach, I give credit where credit's due. Obviously, the greatest stars in the NWA are going to be appearing here week after week, and that's got to bring a little smile on your face when you think that these same stars will be appearing in the months to come at Robarts Arena in Sarasota.
Well, we certainly hope so. The flag will go up and the lights will go on as the first indication when all those stars head our way in Sarasota. Hard shots administered there by Tommy Wright, only to get a reflex.
Whoa!
A strong clothesline by the 291-pound Scott Hall, and what holds Tommy Wright up right now is only the intestinal fortitude that most wrestlers, in fact, every professional wrestler has to show.
You know, I've followed the career of this Scott Hall, and he's made tremendous progress the last couple of years. He's truly a main event wrestler.
There is the form of a Shinonamaki by, of course, we've called it an Intercontinental Sweeper, led by Stan Lane, and the team of Hall and Lane look very strong, and they possibly could be a challenge for that Florida tag title, too.
And Coach, I got a phone call to make.
Yes, I'm sure that the phone booth is quite a welcome sight for J.J. Dillon as we welcome back to the scene once again.
Hello, Coach.
This great, big, handsome blonde guy from Texas. I wanted to stand up a little bit. I look like Billy the Midget next year.
How you doing, Coach?
And Barry Windham, one half of the United States Tag Team title.
Yes, sir, Coach. You know, recently Ronnie Garvin and I won the United States Heavyweight Championship titles. And since winning these championships, Ronnie Garvin was injured at the hands of Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express. But that's a whole nother thing. I'll tell you right now, the reason I'm back here in Florida is after Ed the Bull Gantner. Now, you know what Ed the Bull has done? Is he tried to cripple Kendall Windham. He tried to break his leg, which he did succeed in doing. But now, Mr. Gantner, let me assure you one thing. The reason I am back here is after you. I'm not after the Florida title. I'm not after Humperdinck. I'm after you. Now, the big man that you are, the big strong man that you are, you seem not to be afraid. But I'll tell you what you've done is you've hurt my family, and I am back, and I am going to hurt you like you've hurt me and my family.
Here we are back, and that's him, folks. Big Lex Luger, back in town, going up against Big Steamboat.
Coach, I told you we're looking at a new Lex Luger. You better look hard, you better look fast. And I know Mike Rotundo has got his sights set on the Florida Heavyweight Championship. He better be paying attention to the newest associate of the Four Horsemen. I'm talking about the awesome Lex Luger. And a picture is worth a thousand words, Coach.
That's true it is, and it didn't take long for the powerful Lex Luger to do the job. And here he comes over to the desk. Welcome back, Lex.
You know, it's great to be back in the state of Florida, where it all started. On a one-man path to the top, an associate horseman, James J. Dillon here. I'm coming back to Florida, Barry Windham, in Orlando. Whatever happens, you're on my way. You're going to get squashed. You can count on it.
What a day of wrestling. See you in Orlando tonight, and see you here next week. Coach Donkey fans, see you all.
And welcome to Southern Professional Wrestling. I'm Stan Rhodes, and we have a tremendous hour of wrestling action for you. Quickly want to remind you about Thunderdome. That is tonight in Daytona at the Ocean Center, a tremendous activity. Tonight in Daytona, Thunderdome, two men in and one man out. Also want to remind you, and joining me once again is Coach John Heath. We'll be seeing in just a few minutes the, we're talking about the tag team champions right now, the Florida tag team champions, the Southern boys. We're talking about Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong in action in just a couple of moments.
And as a pre-Thunderdome treat, the fans today will see the world famous, two of the world famous Four Horsemen. Of course, I mean by that, world TV champion Tully Blanchard, along with Arn Anderson and their associate, the powerful Lex Luger. But as a wrestling coach, the guy I'm really looking forward to seeing in action in the ring today, the man I consider the finest classical-style wrestler in the world today, Mike Rotundo.
Not only that, we will be seeing the United States heavyweight champion. I'm talking about Nikita Koloff. That's all coming up. And joining us right now on Southern Professional Wrestling, no strangers indeed, Barry and Kendall Windham. And Kendall, must ask, how are you feeling after that injury from the hands of Ed the Bull Gander?
Well, Stan, you know, having a broken leg, a major part of your body, always seems to get somebody's spirits down, but after laying on my back for the first week of my broken leg, and I sat there, and every day I thought about Ed the Bull Gantner and Sir Oliver Humperdinck. So I got up and went to the gym, and I've been working harder and harder and harder. And every day that I'm there, I'm thinking of Ed the Bull Gantner. I'm thinking of Sir Oliver Humperdinck, and I'm thinking about how much better I'm going to be when I get back off of my broken leg. All I can do is get better. Because when you come back off of a broken leg like this, I'm going to come back at 110, 120, 130% better than I was. And I'm gunning for Ed the Bull Gantner and Sir Oliver Humperdinck and whoever else.
You know, I'll tell you what, Stan. You know, right now, Oliver Humperdinck is running around here with that Florida Heavyweight Championship, which is a disgrace to professional wrestling. But I'll tell you what, Ed Gantner, I've got two good legs right now. And while Kendall's out of action, you're going to have to deal with me. Now, that's the main reason I'm back here in Florida. So, big boy, you better saddle up. Because I'm here mainly for you. And if I have to get rid of you and run you out of Florida, that's exactly what I'll do. So be prepared.
Well, there you have it, the words. We appreciate it. Kendall and Barry Windham, both of their minds right now on Big Ed the Bull Gander. And in just a moment, we're going to be hearing some words from Ric Flair. So stay with us on Southern Professional Wrestling. We'll be back in a moment.
Hello. March 15th, Daytona Beach, Thunderdome. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one.
Take 1 minute to remind everybody out there that Ric Flair
is going to be back in the state of Florida. That's right, the National Wrestling Alliance, the big daddy of the greatest sport of them all, is sending the champ back to Florida because he hears the call of some top flight wrestlers that think they might be man enough to take this from me. You see, my ego says I gotta wrestle the best to be the best. That's what separates me from everybody else. I love to compete against the best competition in all of pro wrestling. The National Wrestling Alliance, number one championship wrestling from Florida, fits right in there because they're with the NWA and they're with old Slick Rick. Space Mountain, if you may. Barry Windham, you want some of it? You don't like me running my mouth? Get in the ring and shut it. Be man enough, Windham, to try and take this from me. Mike Rotundo, I plumb ran you out of town last time I was there. Now you're back. Your humble self, tell everybody, if I get a chance at Ric Flair, I know I can wrest that title from him. Scott Hall, tell you what I do, buddy. I specialize in big guys like you. I take them in that ring, and at about the 30-minute mark, they're gasping for breath. Then they say, I think maybe I'm in the wrong place at the wrong time. Now, Dusty Rhodes, you're back. Championship wrestling from Florida. Dusty Rhodes, Ric Flair, the main event. That's it. The NWA is back. And I don't care if it's West Palm, Orlando, Sarasota, Tampa, Miami. When Ric Flair's there, guys, you know for sure the best in wrestling is going to be in your town. Woo!
Now, there we have it, the words from Nature Boy Ric Flair talking about Dusty Rhodes. And Coach Dusty is going to be joining us on the show just a little bit while longer. He'll be talking about two superpowers, Dusty Rhodes and Nikita Koloff. I'm looking forward to that. Right now, it is the Southern Boys and the New Breed. And we're looking at Tracy Smothers trying his best now against Chris Champion. And this is going to be a tremendous match. Both of these teams are mean, lean fighting machines. Well, Chris missing on that shot. Tracy, a quick shot to the head. Again, another shot to the head and the tag to Sean Royal. And Sean is a little bit worse for wear there after that exchange. Boy, action going rather fast right off the top of the bat.
Two straight drop kicks put the New Breed out of the ring. And right now, an arm bar and stretch and twist by Smothers as Steve Armstrong comes in. Still working on the left arm of Sean Royal. Staying with that arm stretch and bar. And a lot of power coming down onto the deltoid, trying to weaken that left arm. One of the five appendages used by a good wrestler. Steve trapped into that corner over there. Chris Champion in. Arm drag whip. High drop kick. Right on the button, and more attack right onto the upper back. Steve Armstrong trying to set him up for another arm drive whip, and he does. Whips him off, and a chop across the net.
Well, he got that lariat right in there. You talk about motivation, Coach. The New Breed have got to be rather hot about this. Here, looking at an opportunity to get back to the Southern Boys because they are the Florida Tag Team Champion. They took those belts away from the New Breed some weeks ago, and they have got to be hot. Both Chris Champion and Sean Royal going to work right now. Steve Armstrong. Steve ducking underneath that lariat and a body press. He has got Sean Royal down on the mat. Very close to that three count.
And a power wing over by Steve Armstrong, and encases and locks that arm with an outside quarter Nelson style bar on to Sean Royal. And Steve Armstrong, son, of course, of the famous, world famous Bob Armstrong. One of four wrestling Armstrongs right now. What a set of guns all four members of that family have. 21, 20-inch arms. Very strong. And right in the ring right now, we have four young, fine athletes. And there, Chris Champion with a wing over. Drive down onto Steve Armstrong. Has him encased again with an inside bar control, only to release him to put on some, a little bit of an illegal move tactic into the eye area.
Well, it looks, you're right, Coach. Looks as if the New Breed are trying some new tactics with that rake to the eyes, and now he has got Steve Armstrong in a bad way, whipping him over, coming down with that leg across the neck, trying for that press, He's got the two count very close to three before Steve was able to power out of that, trying to get that tag with Tracy Smothers, but unable to do so.
On right whip and a flying clothesline, and only the conditioning and the power of Steve Armstrong is going to keep him in this match right now. He's been hammered and battered by both partners of the new breed. A top Nelson put on there by Sean Royal, only to have it blocked by that far leg hook in there. And he reverses using that half Nelson of his own. The vertical suplex onto, in fact, it's a snap suplex put on to Sean Royal, trying to get out to tag out to his partner, the champion.
Well, both men are rather dazed at this moment. Sean trying to get over to Chris to get that tag. He's just inches away. But first, it was Tracy Smothers getting the tag with Steve Armstrong, and he was able to, well, the tag was made to Chris Champion, and now a little bit of double teaming there. Boom, tremendous leap and flying there, the boot into Chris Champion, and Tracy going to work now against Sean Royal, who was unable to get outside of the squared circle. Almost looked like bowling balls in there. The pin's coming down. The referee obviously knocked down.
Uh-oh. Here comes Jimmy Jett in to try and help out with the officiating. And right now, all four men in the ring at the same time. Champion throwing Steve Armstrong out.
Wait a minute. They've got this flag. Oh! They have bent that flagpole right across the neck of Tracy Smothers. Alternative umpire coming in. Referee came in and got the three count. Unbelievable.
New Breed have defeated the present Florida Tag Champions in there. Southern Boys.
Uh-oh, it's not over. It's not over.
There it is.
There it is.
Bill Alfonso back in the ring and just counting out.
Just as the arm was going up to congratulate the New Breed, the referee came in and quickly changed things around, and now the Southern Boys were able to get that pin.
You know,
well, gentlemen.
He was able to get it. The leg that broke Chase's neck with the rebel flag. Brother, you don't mess around with the rebel flag. That's playing un-American, man.
That's right. We're not through with the knee breed. New breed. We're ready for the mob squad, guys. You ain't beating up no little kids, guys. We're the Southern Boys, and we're ready. Southern born and Southern bred.
We're going for it, Southern style.
Well, there you have the words, Coach, from the Southern Boys. Rather adamant and angry. I would be, too, if I had that flagpole across my throat. But they now will be facing the Mod Squad this evening.
You wouldn't want to be in a Mod Squad shoes tonight.
No, I certainly would not want to be either. We'll be back with more Southern Professional Wrestling right here. You stay with us.
It's you and I, March 15th, Thunderdome. Everybody knows the law. Two men enter, one man leaves.
Welcome back. A gentleman right to my immediate left, who is no stranger to Florida. We're talking about Lex Luger, who is now an associate member with the Four Horsemen. Welcome back.
Well, you know, they always say a picture's worth a thousand words. Right here, two of the Four Horsemen, associate Lex Luger, J.J. Dillon, the elite group of professional wrestling. I said last time I was here, when I expanded, and I decided to leave the state of Florida, broaden my horizons, everyone called, all the promoters, all the managers, except one group, because they are the elite. They are the top, and that's why I've gotten where I've gotten in such a short period of time. I always strive for the best, and this is the best group, the top money makers. This is where it's at. The straw that stirs the drink of professional wrestling right here, the Four Horsemen.
You know, Nate, go ahead. Lex, when you left Florida, you had a tremendous string of victories. You'd beat up a lot of people, won a lot of matches, but you know, like you said when you first came, you can always take that one step higher. And coming to the Four Horsemen, that is Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, and being an associate of ours,
the elite.
The elite in professional wrestling. And that's exactly what you people of Florida are getting to see. The world television champion, Arn Anderson, soon to be the United States heavyweight champion. Right, Arn?
What it all boils down to. Dusty Rhodes, you had the question. Windham had the question. Why would Luger want to be a horseman? Because he likes to wear the finest clothes, drive the finest cars, party with the prettiest women, and where we go, they don't let guys in with dirty blue jeans, t-shirts. You can't meet the dress code. What I'm trying to say, gentlemen, is everybody in this world wakes up every morning
wishing they were somebody else.
We're just happy being ourselves.
That's it, baby.
Guys, you got a little work to do.
Let's do it.
All righty. Well, J.J. Dillon, the administrative director of the Four Horsemen and now an associate member into that. We're talking about Lex Luger. And they are making their way. Telly Blanchard, Arn Anderson, and Lex Luger. And we'll be seeing them in action against Rick Ryder, Vic Steamboat, and Tony D'Amato. Should be a tremendous match, Coach.
It certainly will. And it's true, though. Whenever J.J. Dillon takes charge of anything, those men do go to the top, as we can see by the sartorial splendor and the beautiful rings that he wears on his fingers. He's made it, and all of his horsemen are, too.
Well, they certainly have, and Lex is looking forward to all the fine things that being a member of the Four Horsemen offers. Right now, an associate member going up against Vic Steamboat. Vic back not that long ago. And there you have the administrative director, J.J. Dillon, on the outside.
Arm stretch and twist employed by Lex Luger on the Vic Steamboat. And an equally powerful Arn Anderson comes in. Snapmare over and a tag out to Tony D'Amato. Of course, Arn Anderson has his eyes on the United States Heavyweight Championship. But there's a fellow by the name of Nikita Koloff who has different aspirations.
Whoa.
And a beautiful frontal lift suplex, a twisting suplex, belly to belly by Arn Anderson. And here, demonstrating a little bit of sadistic temperament by rubbing the face of D'Amato into the mat, giving a message to him and every other opponent. This is what you get when you go up against one of the Four Horsemen.
Tremendous athletes, all four of them, and now five, with Lex being the associate member in that. Tremendous indeed. Oh, Lex showing that bicep and that elbow right into the throat of Tony D'Amato. Tony, perhaps a little bit dazed, has got to be a lot dazed. Going down on that knee. Oh, a tremendous knee by Tully Blanchard into the throat of Tony D'Amato.
Lying knee drop pendulum employed there by the world television champion, TV champion, Tully Blanchard. And now almost the fine. Three wrestlers at once over there going into their corner. An almost unheard of rule in the world of wrestling, going in and challenging three guys at once. And there goes, lying out of the ring, the opponent, and working on him, TV champion, Tully Blanchard. And with me at the desk right now, the man of predominance in the world of the Four Horsemen, J.J. Dillon.
Really isn't a whole lot that needs to be said, Coach. I just want to slide over here and just point out one little thing. I think you see a degree of intensity among the former horseman and the associate, Lex Luger, that maybe you don't find in any other combination. And I think that's one of the things that's contributed to our success, the same as contributed to the success of the world heavyweight champion, Nature Boy, Rick Flair, who is also one of the former horsemen.
Well, it's a rather elite class that you're mentioning there, J.J., but of course, as always, in the world of managers, you are known as number one and the elite manager in the world of professional wrestling today. And there, Tully Blanchard demonstrating some high elbow drops down across the throat. And this man is just about out.
They have been punishing every opponent inside of the ring. We're talking about Rick Ryder, Vic Steamboat, Tony D'Amato, the Four Horsemen, two members here, Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson. And now Lex Luger just going to work tremendously on Vic Steamboat, to another drop knee into that throat. And Tully Blanchard making his way in, along with Lex Luger.
Well, these three men have so much confidence in their ability. One at a time, go over and challenge all three men in the opposing corner.
And you know, Stan, of course, what you see may not be very true. Now, yeah, you're going to see a demonstration of the double gourd buster.
Oh! What an acquaintance to the squared circle, the mat there. Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, and they have done it to Vic Steamboat. Well, a tremendous victory for these three gentlemen. No doubt about it. I'm sure Lex has got to be so enthused and ecstatic about now being an associate of the Four Horsemen, Coach.
No doubt about it. Well, you're looking at an awful lot of worldly talent there.
Well, I'll tell you what, tonight is the night for Kevin Sullivan. He'll be with us in a moment. You stay with us. And tonight is the night for Kevin Sullivan. Kevin?
You see, bad news, bad karma has come into your house. You see, you have aligned yourself with the brightest star in the sky, the American dream. But you realize that when he gets close to me, my powers grow. You see, darkness is growing larger inside of me, Bad News, because I am the darkness to your night. I am the rain to your sun. And I am the end to your existence, because tonight it means two of us are going to enter and one man is over. Bad News Allen, I know what the prediction is. Thunderdome is beyond. My existence will live. Thunderdome is mine.
Now, the man you're referring to, Bad News Allen, had these words to say.
And where I come from and the way I was raised, you don't have to sit down and sign a contract with a man. You take a man for his word, you know. And he looks you in the eye and he makes a promise, and you make a promise, and you go out there and you do your best. And then to have him to renege on the promise, which is, to me, you couldn't get no lower than that, you know.
Well, actually, it was even more than reneging.
Right.
It was an insulting gesture, in my opinion.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it actually boiled down to. It was a slap in the face. That's what it came out to.
$1,000. So that's what I'm prepared to do right now.
Kevin Sullivan, you've been my good friend for a long time. It's good to have you back. No contract between us. We're good friends. But here's your part of the money, brother. Here's your $24,500.
And Bad News Allen, thank you very much for your services. There's $500 for you.
Hey, you know what his type get with $500? They go crazy. You know,
they go down to Main Street, down to Bexley.
Don't spend it all in one place.
What Kareem Muhammad is doing at ringside there.
Coming out here and shooting your big mouth off and telling everybody what a spineless cockroach I am. I paid you $500 for a job you didn't even do. I took you out of the ghetto, brother. And I'm
going to you get your heart to do, huh? Who the hell are you?
You know, one of the most important things, I think, is a man's word and his name, you know. And when you get a reputation that you cannot be trusted, I think you have nothing to look forward to in life, you know.
And then he dragged me into that situation.
Yes.
He gave me that additional money.
Well, then again, that was just another slap in the face, really, you know.
Bad news, we don't have a whole heck of a lot of time here, but Sir Oliver Humperdinck wanted you to have this envelope. He said that should be full restitution.
Well, I'd just like to say one thing, Gordon. I don't like the man. I don't trust him. But I have the scrapbooks. I'm in this for the bank book. If he's willing to give me restitution here, then, because I have to agree with him on one thing, somebody is definitely going to get hurt with this situation here. Let me see what we got here. The man did it again to me. He did it again to me. What is this, the new math? This is not even close to what he owes me. But I tell you one thing, I'm going to take it out on his hide right now.
Uh-oh. Well, it certainly isn't $12,500, I can tell that right now. But he's, headed out on the ring. There goes Bad News Allen. Bad News Allen headed for the ring, and he's caught very quickly by Kevin Sullivan coming in. But we've got a Pier 6er going. A real Pier 6er going now.
Not too terribly long ago, of course, that you had a chance to wreak some sort of revenge on Kevin Sullivan during a television match that ended up off in the doggone street.
Kevin Sullivan and Bad News Allen. And the fury of this battle goes on and on and on. As you can see, Kevin Sullivan smashed into that police car outside. And
let me ask you another question regarding this entire situation in the Florida Heavyweight Championship. And that had to be the bitterest blow of all when you stepped into the ring with this 270-pound Sir Oliver Humperdinck, who's anything but an athlete.
Exactly.
and then to have the indignity happen to you that did happen. Kevin Sullivan. He's been right. The bane of your existence. Quite possibly you'll be able to settle that issue once and for all at the Thunderdome.
Yeah, I think this is important. He's been a thorn in my spine, you know, and I'm looking forward now to this Thunderdome for people that probably don't understand what's going to happen. Is that both of us are going to be put into a cage-type ring, but it's going to have a top over it. It's going to have a dome-type top over it. And there's not going to be no referees. Two men going to walk in there, and only one's going to walk out.
Enough talk, bad news. Talk is for lovers. Tonight we go to war.
Well, he's got that right, Coach. The talking is over. It is tonight, Thunderdome, Daytona at the Ocean Center, 8 p.m. Tremendous. And Kevin, not wasting any time up against Jason Sterling. Tremendous slaps. He's not wasting any time at all. He is taking out vengeance early.
You can just see the anticipation and excitement in Sullivan by using all his energy against his opponent, Jason Sterling, and it's all over after a pile driver, and bad news may be in for a hard time tonight.
Well, it is indeed. Very quick, in short order, Kevin Sullivan disposed of Jason Sterling. Unbelievable. Jason reeling now from that. Well, you stay with us. In a matter of moments, we're going to be hearing some words from Jimmy Valiant. Stay with us. Boogie Woogie Man Valiant, and you'll be seeing him in action tonight. And we're talking about the Thunderdome at Daytona. Matches begin tonight at 8 p.m. at the Ocean Center. And right now it is Mike Rotunda. We're talking about the All-American from Syracuse going up right now against Bob Cook. Well, Bob right now having the upper hand momentarily, getting that elbow. And now the wing over by Mike Rotunda.
An inverted wicker hip lock thrown in there by Mike Rotundo. He did not use too much hip. He didn't have to with all the upper shoulder power that he has. An elbow drop down to Bob Cook. Bob Cook, supinator power's out of there. However, I'm sure that in this match, if we're keeping points, it'll be a little lopsided on one side of the page where it says MR. And there, Bob Cook trying to come out of there with a little bit of a little legitimate move, kicking the abdominal area and staying right on the abdominal area of Mike Rotundo, the man who's still seeking the Florida Heavyweight Championship because he knows that four men held the Florida title right before they become the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. A drop kick in there by Big Mike, who arm drag whips Cook off, and there it is, the patented Mike Rotundo airplane spin. And Stan, as I've always said, once you see that shot, it's all over but the shouting. And there it is, Darlene Cook, wrap up and a pick and a win for the man chasing the Florida Heavyweight title and head the bull Gantner, Mike Rotundo.
Well, he did indeed. It was a quick three count, and there he was. And joining us right now, Ron Simmons. Speaking of All-American, good to have you here. Ron, we're looking forward to you at Thunderdome.
And I can't tell you what a pleasure it is for me to even be a part of it. You know, I've been involved in some big events in my life, but this by far is going to be unmatched by any that I've been had a chance to be take part in. I'm so thrilled about it. And from start to finish, it's going to be nothing but the best wrestling that anybody's ever seen.
Well, absolutely. Mike, tremendous win there.
Thank you very much.
You got your eyes on other things in concern with Ed the Bull Gantner, I understand.
Well, you know, Stan, I came here to the state of Florida for a reason. That's a Florida heavyweight title. I want that strap around my waist because I know it guarantees me a shot at Ric Flair. I know Ric Flair's a great champion, but I want that shot at him. I think I can do the job. It's going to take a lot of hard work, and I'd like to say hello to all the Florida fans. It's great to be back in Florida.
All right, fellas, we appreciate you being here. In a moment, we'll return to more of Southern Professional Wrestling. Stay with us.
March 15th, Ocean Center, Daytona Beach. News against Sullivan, Thunderdome. Two men enter, one man leaves.
Back to the professional wrestling, and in the ring right now, the man holding the United States Heavyweight Championship belt. We're talking about Nikita Koloff, tremendous athlete, and he's going up against Jack Hart.
Well, here's the man who would have been in the 1984 Olympics had there not been a boycott. And right now, Hart hoping to get a real quick exchange on one of the most powerful men in the entire world. Of course, I'm referring to Nikita Koloff, a man who is very Americanized nowadays, loves fast cars, beautiful women, and what a powerful shot. The Russian sickle disposed Jack Hart, pushed off by a two-hand press.
Well, tremendous. Joining us, Dusty Rhodes, American Dream.
Orlando, Florida. Welcome back, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Let me tell you something. Next time, I want the highway patrol. I want the policemen prepared for. You understand? I want all my people in there. Let me tell you now, you're looking at it. The superpowers, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, Nikita Koloff, the devil himself, Jimmy Sullivan, Thunderdome, tonight, Ben News Allen is the Isles of Mars. I told you, baby, I said, beware of the Isles of Mars. And we gonna get funky like a monkey at Thunderdome tonight, baby. But bad news is bad news for you. And Dick Murdoch, Ivan Koloff, Pierre Trump, you got the deal now in the state of Florida with Nikita Koloff and Dusty Rhodes. Superpower, we back and we right, Jack.
It's a pleasure to be here with my good friend Dusty Rhodes, the Super Ponder. You see, Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Pietrov, Dick Murdoch, Ivan Koloff, you tell them, Umeni Tovrieda, yeah, to be Shattery Cardina. You tell them, Ivan Koloff, and there's somebody else I want to talk about. That's a urine problem. I understand you have been up on Big Japan Tour. Maybe it's just a little bit too hot around here. Too much competition from Nikita. Because you know I am from this close to defeating you, Rick Brown. You are a great champion, Rick Brown. You have been a great champion. I, Nikita Koloff, am going to be a great world heavyweight champion. Rick Brown, get ready.
One other thing, Stan Rhodes and Johnny.
The devil got to know that in the heart of Baton Rouge Island is a little bit of the American dream. Beware of the Ides of March.
Well, he's right about that, Coach. Beware of the Ides of March. We're talking about Thunderdome right now. Scott Hall and Stan Lane. They're getting ready to take on Jack Towers and Chick Donovan. Boy, the action is heating up, Coach.
What a lot of energy when you have the superpowers right at your desk. Now, of course, I'm speaking of the one and only Dusty Rhodes, who thousands of fans during the week in the different towns I've been in say, please say welcome back to Dusty Rhodes for me, will you, Coach? And it's a very sincere welcome back by everyone, including Stan Rhodes and myself.
Well, not only that, Coach, I've had many times been asked, am I related? No, I'm not, but I certainly wouldn't mind being to the American dream. Right now, Chick Donovan has the upper edge with Stan Lane and the tag out to Jack Towers.
Nice standing switch in there, only to have it caught off there by Stan Lane, who then caught the oncoming opponent into that corner side headlock by Big Scott Hall. And a strong shoulder in there by that almost 300-pound fella from Tampa, Florida. High inverted wizard lock over. Doesn't use that hip so much. He doesn't have to. Very much like Mike Rotundo. And there, a high leg drop down on the opponent, and he's in trouble.
He certainly is. When you're in the arms of Scott Hall, although now Scott's taking a couple of shots there from Jack Towers, this is only momentary, as you can see. Scott Hall with those big biceps and arms and elbows right into the chest. Oh, tremendous, tremendous shoulder and arm right into the throat of Jack Towers. I'm surprised he was able to get up now. A quick one by Stan Lane. They're going to work on that throat.
That Chinanamaki, that's the type of sleeper, oriental sleeper. And that's all there is to it.
That's right.
Jack Towers in bye-bye land.
Well, that he certainly is. You stay with us. We'll be back with more Southern Professional Wrestling in just a moment.
March 15th, Thunderdome. Everybody knows the law. Two men enter, one man leave. Two men enter, one man leave. Two men enter, one man leave. March 15th, Thunderdome.
And welcome back. I've been joined by Sir Oliver Humperdinck and the man who apparently now holds the new Florida heavyweight title.
The man who is presently holding and doing my bidding in the Florida Championship races at the Bull Gettner right here, and in no better hand could I have placed that title. You know, everybody's coming to the state of Florida now gunning for the champion, because it's true that four world champions held this belt previously. Well, let me tell you something, guys. I'm not afraid of anybody, but I got the belt right here on a man that I know can defend it for me and will defend it for me at the drop of a hat. Now, Mike Rotundo, you want it real bad. But, guy, I don't think you can get the job done. You understand what I'm talking about? You're a great amateur, but we're talking about the pro ranks right here and the belt that means everything to me in Big Ed. Now, as you all know, the cards and letters keep coming in. The Dream Day contest will end tonight in Daytona at Thunderdome. But let's just pause now for a moment with the big man himself, Big Ed.
You know something? You pencil neck punks, about the only thing you've ever curled out there is maybe a 12-ounce beer can. But as myself and Kareem Muhammad back there and Harry know, there's nothing more exhilarating than to feel a cold steel and that blood pump through your arms. Nothing more exhilarating, nothing more satisfying than feeling that blood flow, baby. Almost nothing. Yeah.
Well, there he was. Big Ed the Bull, and he is teamed up with the Barbarian, a close personal friend. Right now, superstar Billy Dundee, and they're in the ring with Black Magic and Jimmy Backlund joining us right now at the desk. Superstar Billy Dundee.
Let me tell you, I just come over this podium at a little class here. I wouldn't be them two guys in that ring with the Barbarian and Big Ed for all the tea in China. Now, we started something the first night we came to Orlando. The Barbarian and I knocked was on Handsome Jimmy Valley, the Boogie Woogie Band. Somebody wants to call him somebody from the streets. That's exactly what he is. And in Lakeland, on the 21st of March, Jack, we're taking him out. The Barbarian will be there, I'll be there, and the greatest tag team in professional wrestling, the March Squad, will be there. And you know what? The March Squad, our daddy, their cops weren't bad, and you don't get nothing better than they are. When they wanted the job done, they sent them in. And the way they done it, somebody got mad, so they asked them to leave the police force, and that's exactly what they did. Now they work for the superstar. Now look at this awesome power, daddy. Now look at this. See that? Woo! The Barbarian or Big Ed could beat both them guys at the same time. Now look at this. This is the greatest athlete in professional wrestling today. You're going to have to say how do you do? You're just going to sit there and watch the picture in amazement like all the rest of the rednecks.
Well, you're describing it fairly
accurately. You're right. Take a look at this, Daddy. Would you like to meet him on a Saturday night somewhere? No, you wouldn't. And neither does any other professional athlete.
Power slam demonstrated by the Barbarian.
Hey, Coach, I'm glad you picked up on that, son.
And once again, in comes Ed. The bull,
Gantu.
No, I will want to meet the Barbarian Saturday night, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday night, isn't
it? You're right about that, Coach.
Big Ed, he ain't doing too bad either, is he now? Oh, Humphrey and I, we go back a long way, brother.
Tremendous. Ed, the bull Gantu, right now quitting Black Magic, who is rather dizzy with the turnbuckle, one after
Black
another. Jimmy Backlund coming back in for more. Ed, not wasting any time at all.
Ed the Bull Gantner and the Barbarian almost defiant of the competition across the ring from him. And a top Nelson put in there with a high vertical suplex. And Jim Backlund, a former Florida High School state wrestling champion, in a lot of trouble against two men entirely out of his class.
Did you say that boy was a high school wrestler?
If he was a former Florida High School state wrestling champion.
Now he's up here with the big boys, son. High school wrestler and professional wrestler. Two different men. Now watch this hole.
Oh,
they don't teach you this professional wrestling, Daddy.
Put on a double ankle lace, twisted it over.
Hey, Coach, you know what you're talking about, don't you? We got to take our hat off to you, boy. How do you do? You got to land a few of them names for them holes, son. Now, watch this. Awesome.
Power lifted and dropped against him.
That's what's going to happen to the Boogie Woogie in the 21st, brother.
Arm drag whip across that far rope.
Whoa! Tremendous shot making mincemeat of Jimmy Backlund. An awesome team, and the Bull Gantner and the Barbarian.
Watch this, baby. Watch this. Oh, watch this.
I don't think they should put these guys in the room with human beings. Wow.
The Barbarian taking off right into Jimmy Backlund.
That's like a big jumbo jet landing on your back.
Well, that is it. There's not much I can say to discount the words of superstar Billy Dundee. He is absolutely correct, Coach. An awesome team. Big Ed the Bull Gantner. The Barbarian.
Almost no way to describe the power of those two guys, especially the Barbarian. What a day of wrestling it's been with Dusty Rhodes and Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard and Lex Luger and J.J. Dunn. What a cast.
Tremendous action that we have had, and of course visited and once now again.
Superstar Bill Dundee, Sir Oliver Humperdinck, the Barbarian and the Bull Gantner, all the way to the top.
Welcome to Southern Professional Wrestling. I'm Buddy Colt, your host for today, and with me today is Coach John Heath to add his expert commentary. And also, we have another exciting personality and superstar, Bill Dundee. But you know, since Mike Rotunda has become the Florida heavyweight champion, he has been getting challenges from throughout the country. And now we are going to have, we just got found out that Dory Funk Jr., the former World's Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, is issuing challenges to Mike Rotunda. He would like to regain that world's title, and he has to go through Mike Rotunda first. Now, Coach, we have some great matches here today.
Yes, we do, and we'll be seeing Mike Rotunda in action later on in this program, as we will be seeing the World Tag Team Champions in action very soon, and they'll be in action at the Bayfront on Saturday, April the 4th. Among others today, it'll be, of course, Big Ed the Bull Gantner, the Tahitian Prince, and a host of others. However, our guest today, you know, really deserves the title of superstar in the world of wrestling. He's a fantastic wrestler, and he's a manager of champions along with the Barbarian and the Florida Tag Team Champions, the Mod Squad. However, when he invaded the world of Elsa Maxwell, who is the world's most famous party giver, he ran into a bit of a trouble.
What can I say? There's a million comedians out of work, and Coach Heath wants to be a comedian alongside Buddy Colt. I guess you thought that was funny, both of you, right?
Yes, I did. Well, I was rolling on the floor.
Oh, I'm sure you was, and so was I. Well, I'm going to tell you something, Armstrong, and your whole stinking family. On April the 4th in the Bayfront, I'm going to be there, the Mud Squad's going to be there, and the Barbarian's going to be there, and I hope you and your whole stinking brood of kids is there, including that Smothers kid. And I got my doubts about what his name is, Armstrong. Now, I don't like you, brother. We was out here, nuts floating. I told all the people was going to have a party, went to great expense, and you come out and ruined it. Well, this ain't no promise, Jack. This is a threat, and you can take it any way you want. Bullet Bob Armstrong. I don't care about you little illiterate kids. I'm just worried about you, and I'm taking you out, punk, because I don't like you. So when you go to bed at night, you see this face, Armstrong, and this is the one that's going to haunt you. Either you or me is leaving Florida, and that's a promise from the superstar to you, Jack. Now, you know, have your show back.
You know, another great match that will be at the Bayfront April 4th, the World Tag Team Champion, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, along with his partner, Ravishing Rick Rude, and their manager, Paul Jones, will be there. Now, we have a very exciting videotape of the World Heavyweight Tag Team Champions in action. Let's go. Right now, you see the opponents, Heath Patterson and Mike Zumati, awaiting the arrival of the World Tag Team Champions. And here they are, Paul Jones, the manager, along with the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, and Ravishing Rick Rude. Coming into the ring.
Buddy, let me interrupt you just for a minute. That team there in the Memorial Cup is the number one seed, brother. That's the team to beat. They're the world champions. And may I add, the Mud Squad seeded. The Barbarian, the Superstar, is going to be in the cup. So, what can I tell you? Maybe we'll get down to that and we'll really see how bad they are, huh?
Well, no doubt there's many great tag team combinations throughout the country that are geared up for the World Tag Team Champions. And right now, that was quite a maneuver on the part of the tag team champion there.
Now, this hole here, he patented this and called it the Rude Awakening. And more pushing his feet than awakening, wouldn't you think that?
Well, and the World Tag Team Champions have a very good victory here. Along with our manager, Paul Jones. And you, right there, you see them in action. We'll be seeing more of them this coming April 4th at the Bayfront Center. We'll be right back after this.
Now, Friday, April 10th, starting at 7 o'clock there. Saturday, April the 11th, it starts at 8 o'clock that night. 24 of the greatest tag teams in the world, four of the $1 million prize of the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Plus, on the first night in the cage, Ole Anderson against Big Bubba. Then the special added match on the second night is for the world title as Ric Flair defends against Barry Windham. Here they are, the number one seed in the tournament, the NWA World Tag Team Champions, Paul Jones, Ravishing Rick Rude, and the Raging Bull.
The cup, my men have claimed it. The $1 million, my men have claimed it. All they've got to do is go in the ring and take it. And that's exactly what they're going to do. You see, they are the world champions. They are number one seed. I have all the confidence in the world and the world champion.
Tony Schiavone, the $1 million has already been spent. Bull and I, we've already spent the $1 million. Now comes the fun part. We get to cut through each team, all 23 of them, one at a time. And that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to put them all down in Boston.
In Baltimore, baby, we're going to come. We're going to see, and we're going to conquer, Daddy, because it's all about everybody else is wandering around scrambling at the last minute, trying to get their heads together, trying to get their partners united. Well, see, we are united, as Mr. Jones brought it together, the R&R Express, which stands for Ravishing and Raging, the number one team that everybody knows in the world today. Everybody's going to be wearing the new look, the R&R look. Not anything else, because when you look awesome, you are awesome. But when the awesome twosome come together, the official thing is we will be the winners of the cup, because we have already spent it, we already won it, and we know that everybody else ain't united the way we are. In unity, we stand together, Daddy.
Here they don't sign off with Texas.
star Bill Dundee was sitting here beside me, and he was scheduled to be here for the remainder of the day, but he saw the Southern boys along with Bullet Bob Armstrong come in the ring, and he made a hasty retreat. Right now, this next match is a six-man tag team contest with the Southern boys, Gracie, Smothers, Steve Armstrong, and Bullet Bob Armstrong going up against Bob Cook, Luis Estilla, and Tony D'Amata. And right now, it looks like Steve Armstrong is trying to make short work of Bob Cook.
Well, he has an armbar and stretch on, tugging his partner, Tracy Smothers. I would imagine that superstar Bill Dundee had a case of Armstrongitis and was getting out of the area as quickly as possible. And here, a double arm stretch, and fine chop in there by Bullet Bob Armstrong, a man who I remember many years ago when I first saw those arms. Said to myself, it's time for me to get out of this profession and in a hurry. And coming off that middle rope and putting on an outside bar against Bob Cook, Tracy Smothers. Cook tags out. In comes Louis Estilla with a side headlock and a shot to the chest.
Coach, you have a history with Bullet Bob Armstrong, as I do myself. Several years ago, right here in Florida, I had many matches against Bullet Bob Armstrong, and I can tell you, the ability of this man is just terrific. He's a great wrestler, and his two sons, Brad and Steve, have turned out to be. Nice drop toe hold on the part of Tracy Smothers there, and it looks like he's turning Luis Estilla over, trying for 10, but Luis Estilla says, none of that yet. I'm not quite ready. I'm not going to be ready, and you're going to have to do it the hard way. Tagging in Steve Armstrong. I tell you, with a man like Luis Estilla, you have to watch him because you never can tell with Luis Estilla when he might be right on top of him.
High arm stretch and twist, and again a side headlock put on by Luis Estilla. Estilla attempting to tag out one of his partners. Already got himself thrown off by Steve Armstrong. Almost tripped up, close over, and a high lariat. Louis Estilla in a bit of trouble as Armstrong comes in and applies an inside bar. Estilla with a nice near late scissor takedown on Armstrong and a front face lock holding him in check. And Mr. Tony D'Amato comes in and applies the turnbuckle and head into the corner. And here, an arm drag whip out. And D'Amato only have it reversed by Steve Armstrong.
It won't be much longer before the brother, Brad Armstrong, will also be coming here to the Sunshine State Wrestle. It will be like a complete family reunion with Bullet Bob, Steve Armstrong, and Brad Armstrong. And I tell you, Tracy Smothers is just like one of the family. He's been tag teaming with Steve for such a long time. Their moves are coordinated together, and right now it's Tracy Smothers tagging back out to Steve Armstrong. See a lot of tag team combination action here. These men train together, travel together, and you can very well tell that by the way they wrestle together. We're forcing Tony D'Amato right back into the ropes, over to his corner, straight, and tagging back out to Tracy. Good high drop kick over that top rope. This could be a pinning combination, Coach.
High drop kick in there by Tracy, and now brought it down into single arm crucifix all right there. Tracy back in balance, and another near leg scissor takedown by Tracy Smothers. And control once again along to the left arm of Tony D'Amato. The secret, as you well know, buddy, is for a tag team to be able to tag out while you're still comparatively fresh, not get yourself, as we say, blown up on a single man. And the coordination between Armstrong and Smothers has been fantastic. And here, Bob Cook coming in after applying some boots in the midsection. Snap there, elbow drop down on the thorax region. And Steve in a little bit of trouble. You better get over there and tag up for this.
That's right. One of the best things to do in a tag match is stay close to your corner, get that fresh man in there. Many times in tag team combination, one man might try to stay in there and grandstand too long, but he should be looking for his partner to get that fresh man in the ring. And there's Bob Armstrong in action. A lot of action with Bullet Bob Armstrong. It looks like he might have the best of Bob Cook. And after 1, 2, 3, let's see if we can get these men over here for a quick interview if we might. That was a good victory for these men. Well, I believe they're walking over this way. And the Southern boys are really out to regain that Florida tag team title. Looks like they're about to walk off. Had to get them over here. It's really good to see my old buddy, or enemy, you might say, from years ago. Bob, good to see you again. You know, we've had a lot of tough matches in the past, but glad to see you're just as tough as ever.
Well, it's good to be with my boys here, both of them, you know. We get together, and the Armstrong motto is a winner never quits and a quitter never wins. And I noticed Billy Dundee had an important engagement somewhere. I saw to it that he got a good bite of that celebration cake, and I hope his mouth's big enough to take this down his throat with open up. Now, Brad Armstrong's coming. We're going to even up the odds here. It's been kind of like a 3-on-2 situation. Now it's 3-on-3. That's one time that Dundee had his cake and ate it too. You don't get that very often. But it's good to be with the Southern boys, both my boys. I love you both, brother. And we got family faith, and brother, that's unbreakable.
Bob, thank you very much. It's good having you here, and we'll be right back after this.
But I'm busted here, and I got Dixie on my mind.
Florida heavyweight wrestling champion Mike Rotunda getting ready to go up against a very worthy adversary in Colt Steele.
Team out of Syracuse, of course, weighing in there about 245 pounds. One of the things that people don't realize about the man who has just made a reversal on that hammerlock is he is one of the finest hip wrestlers in the entire world. By a hip wrestler, I mean a man who is not only able to control his own hips to his advantage, but control the hip of his opponent. Now, that is the final fine art of great wrestling, when you can control hips. There, however, it was reversed on him very nicely by Colt Steele, the 240-pounder from Reno, Nevada, quickly retaliating with a side hip lock and throwing that hip in, as I said once before. Mike Rotunda putting the man in a position of jeopardy, almost a pinning combination. However, he saw that at ringside, out came Cajun Cox, Kevin Sullivan,
and the Tahitian Prince.
Prince Samu.
You know, with Kevin Sullivan and these other two men here that seem to be somehow under the supervision of Kevin Sullivan right now, Mike Rotunda has to keep an eye on these men as well as his opponent. And so sometimes this is a diversionary tactic. With all three of these men, any one of them is a threat to the Florida heavyweight title. Now, Mike Rotunda, of course, being the Florida heavyweight champion, which is a stepping stone to the world title currently held by NWA world champion Ric Flair. Four champions in the past have gone on from being the Florida champion to the world's heavyweight champion. And right now, Mike Rotunda full well knows this, as does Kevin Sullivan. And right now, with these men that he has with him, they are all dangerous threats. So Mike Rotunda has to really keep his eye on the men outside the ring as well as his opponent, Coach.
Well, that's a strong psychological ploy, and I'm sure it's engineered by none other than Kevin Sullivan, who consistently seems to round out certain people to join into his camp. There we saw a nice semi-grand aperture suplex displayed by Mike, who now controls the hips. Well, Colt Steele with a nice low ride, a low center force ride into the hip area. He had a wing bar in there, however, it was power winged over by Colt Steele, only to have, when he stood up, we find that Mike Rotunda was in control with an inside bar. Clean break? No, not quite.
See, right now, Mike Rotunda is at a disadvantage because he constantly has to be on alert, because you can never tell exactly what a man like Kevin Sullivan might have in mind. Right now, this Colt Steele is a well-developed man, putting his big forearm on the upper chest of Mike Rotunda. Coming back for an airplane spin. The airplane spin, and that is normally all she wrote. This should be it for Colt Steele. That's it. Another victory for Mike Rotunda. Coach, why don't you see if you can get Mike Rotunda there for an interview at ringside. Mike Rotunda still getting ready to come outside to interview with the coach.
Well, we have joining us right now, Kendall Winneman. Kendall, welcome back, and I hope everything's coming along fine with that leg.
Thank you, Coach. Everything's getting better. You know that every week gets me one step closer back to that ring. You know, I've been crawling, feels like, for 8 weeks trying to get back to the ring. Well, finally, the weeks are narrowing down, and Ed Gettner, I'm coming for you. You know, I was watching just a minute ago, Kevin Sullivan's out here running around the ring over Mike's match. You know, Mike's a very close part of the family to me. And like I said before, blood's thicker than water. And he's got these guys running around here that are friends or buddies or whatever. Hey, we'll stick together through the end, through thick and thin, through no matter what it is.
Well, Mike, uneasy lies ahead to Where's the Crown. Not only do we hear that Dory Funk is out after the world title, which means he has to go through you, but now we see Ed the Bull Gantner's on your trail. Of course, we have Tijin Khan, the priest.
This is all what they want right here, Coach. You know, they're going to be coming out of the woodwork after this Florida heavyweight title, because this is your ticket to see Ric Flair in any arena around the country and a chance at the world heavyweight title. I'm going to hang on to this, boys, so you can come, Tijin Khan. Dory Funk Jr., doesn't matter. Kevin Sullivan, you're going to have to get it done right here in this ring, and you're going to have to go through me. So hang on, boys, for the ride of your life.
I just say one more thing. It's not going to be no more 2-on-1, 3-on-1. It's 1-on-1.
And words from guys that can do it. We'll be right back.
That will be the Mulkey brothers, Bill and Randy Mulkey, going up against the team of Stan Lane and Ron Simmons. Stan Lane, one half of the Fabulous Ones, formerly Florida Heavyweight Tag Team Champion, and Ron Simmons, former Florida Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. Very cautiously watching Bill Mulkey there, tying up. Well, going right in for it, right in for a big high body slam. Well, excuse me here. Looks like we're being joined by Shasta Watley.
Let me tell you something. Y'all have messed up Florida this about Ron Simmons. Messed up Florida that about Ron Simmons. Well, let me tell you what I think. I think he's a Florida nothing. That's right. I'm the one that said it. Ron Simmons from Florida nothing. Bobby Bowden can't help him now. We're in a square circle. You know that? Steve Spurrier can't help Ron Simmons now. No, not in that square circle. Ain't now one of them football fans coming in that square circle to help Ron Simmons. And everybody knows that he's going to need some help. When the Shaka man gets there with his heathen whooping clothes on. Because I got some heathen whooping deals inside me. And I'm going to tell you right now, Ron Simmons going to be the first heathen that I whoop. First whooping heel been in a long time. And I just now got good at it. And heathen, I can't wait. Ain't that right, Coach?
Just a moment, Shasta. You can stand here at the desk and talk into a microphone all this rhetoric, but there's a little bit different when you actually get in the ring with Ron Simmons rather than standing here and mouthing off about what you're going to do.
Different. Let me tell you something, buddy. Coach, it ain't different. See, all those wrestling fans out there know that Shasta Watley is a ring veteran. They all know. I know the trick to the trade. Everybody knows that I lay down a whooping on a human being.
Well, it sounds very good what you're going to do, but it all remains to be seen if you can back up what you say, because I'll tell you, Shasta, Ron Simmons is not a pushover for anybody.
I'm telling you what, I know he ain't a pushover because of his accolades so far on the athletic field, but the thing still remains. Can he handle the shot command? See, I was world great at wrestling too, so therefore, can he handle a man that really knows how to get down in a square circle? Oh yeah, he handled Monkey Mania because Monkey Mania is experienced too, but can he handle a veteran that knows everything? Can he do it? No, he can't do it. Ain't that right, Coach? Ain't that right?
There's no doubting about the wrestling ability of one Shasta Watley, as I've seen through years of experience. However, we've seen some beautiful moves in this match also. At one time, we saw a far side roll with an arm lever takedown, and there we see the pinning combination that wins this match with an outside leg trap, and your winners are Ron Simmons and Stan Lane.
Well, we've been joined here at the desk by Big Scott Hall. Scott, good to have you here.
Thank you, buddy. Coach, you know, it's not my nature to come out here and cry over things that happened in the ring. You know, if a better man can beat me in the ring 1, 2, 3, I'll be the first one to go up to him and shake him hand and say, hey, you got the best of me. You're the better man on this given night. But on our sister show, just yesterday, aired in front of millions of viewers, Ed Gantner, along with Shaska Watley and Sir Oliver Humperdinck, embarrassed Big Scott. Well, Ed, you know, I'm not out here. It's not my nature to come out here and shout and scream, but it seems like nice guys finish last. I've been hearing that all my life, and I guess it's true. Well, I'm 6'6", close to 300 pounds, and I've got rights. So Ed Gantner, Shaska Watley, and Sir Oliver Humperdinck, start watching your back, because from now on, it's no more Mr. Nice Guy.
Well, you know, from what I know of Sir Oliver Humperdinck, his crew, Big Ed Gantner, you really do have to watch your own back around them. We'll be right back after this.
Tag team tournament coming to Baltimore at the arena on Friday, April 10th, and that starts at 7 o'clock on Friday night. Then on Saturday, April the 11th, and it starts at 8 o'clock. 24 of the greatest tag teams in the world for $1 million in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, plus two added events. On the first night, in the cage, it's Big Bubba against Ole Anderson. Let's bring in Jim Cornette and Big Bubba.
You know, Ole Anderson's running around here talking about, he thinks he's Buford Buster. He's carrying a big stick, a big baseball bat, talking about a 32-ounce Louisville Slugger. Well, let me tell you something, Ole Anderson. 32 ounces, 357 pounds, and this is a Louisville Slugger, baby. And he uses those things that Hillerich and Bresby puts out for toothpicks, darling. So you remember that, Ole Anderson. We're going to teach you a thing or two about being tough. And then, that tournament, 24 teams, $1 million. Everybody knows how important it is. All I'm going to say, whoever we face, the Midnight Express are going to go to the finals and go all the way. And we're going to be drinking out of that cup and spending that $1 million.
On the second night, the special added match for the world title, Ric Flair, Barry Windham.
What a night it's going to be. Think about it. By the time I climb in that ring, two of the four horsemen will have won $1 million. Big Bubba, one of my main people, will have destroyed Ole Anderson. And all I got to do is walk that aisle. Woo, looking as only I can look. The man on the top of the most prestigious sporting event of all time, the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Barry Windham, you're back because you want to be the man. You're back because you want the notoriety. You want the prestige. You want to ride around in limousines. You want good-looking women all over the place. And you want this, the World Heavyweight Championship. Well, in Baltimore, baby, all you got to do is beat Space Mountain. Ha ha! Woo!
Well, I've been joined by Sir Oliver Humperdinck.
We need no introduction.
Well, I was just to say, both
we
of you are
no
former
champions. We need nobody telling anybody who we are, because everybody knows that you're looking at the Florida heavyweight champion when you're looking at me. That's right. Sir Oliver Humperdinck is still the Florida heavyweight champion, no matter what Mike Rotundo goes around telling all his fans. No matter what, he goes around telling all those little girls that are following him around. No matter what, before you can be the champion, you've got to beat the champion. I gave Big Ed that belt to hold for me, and through a fluke, which my lawyer, Saul Leibowitz, is taking care of right now, on Upper Wacker Drive in Chicago, everybody knows where he is. Mike Rotundo, you have no claim to that title. You have no right at all to walk around as the Florida heavyweight champion. I am the Florida heavyweight champion, and everybody knows that the title cannot be won any other way than by beating the man that holds it. I'm the man right here. Now, you can walk around and be a gold-plated champion if you want to, but Big Ed, the man right here, is going to put you to the test, and if Leibowitz doesn't get it done, Big Ed will. Now, Mike Rotundo, you're shooting off your mouth about this and that, this guy coming for you, that guy coming for you. But you better remember one thing. There ain't nobody around the world tougher than what you're looking at right here in Big Ed the Bull Gantner. And he's breathing hot and heavy down your trail. And right now, buddy Colt, we're going to beat up some punk that has the guts to get in the ring with Big Ed.
You know, Sir Oliver, I think one of the biggest miscarriages of justice in the history of wrestling in the world was the day that you walked out here with that Florida heavyweight title. Says everybody in the state of Florida throughout the United States, and that was very short-lived. Right now, this next match is Big Ed the Bull Gander going up against Eddie Roberts. Eddie Roberts, well-conditioned athlete, excellent wrestler, good background in amateur wrestling, but right now, I'll tell you, he's going to have to stay on his toes against Big Ed the Bull. Ed the Bull really wants to regain that Florida heavyweight title, which is kind of an ambiguous situation. Did he really have it, in fact, if at all?
Well, of course, that controversy will go on for quite a few months. Although right now, Eddie Roberts again facing the psychological factor, not only going against a man out weighing by about 40 pounds, but also having to look outside the ring and seeing that entourage of Kevin Sullivan and Sir Oliver Humperdinck, he should bring Samu, Kijo Khan, and air with a deep half stuck in there and a high vertical souffle. I thought that might be all she wrote, but no, the sophisticated street. Ed the Bull Gander comes out, unless he's the future opponent. This is like a game where you're going against Ed the Bull Gander. And here, using the rope as an ally, and also part of a front Nelson, choking Eddie Roberts across the neck. There, attacking the same spot in the thorax region. In the bag, it appears, for Ed the Bull Gander.
You know, looking at the coalition here of Sir Oliver Humperdinck, Kevin Sullivan, they always say that there is no formal contract between them, but look at the right here, the Tahitian friends right there. Ed the Bull had the referee's attention distracted, but if there is no formal contract, there must at least be a verbal contract. Look at them with the camaraderie between these men.
Well, they say that there's a written contract between Sullivan and Humperdinck, however, might be a coalition of the years. Wow, strong arm drag whip into the ropes, and as he came off, charged him with a charging lariat, and that is it.
Well, there's a victory for Ed the Bull Gantner and the incomplete entourage at ringside. We'll be right back after this.
Maybe just a little bit harder right now. But it comes time for a Crockett Cup. I have said before, and I'm going to say again, just as you see me stand here today, I will stand in the ring at the Crockett Cup by the side of my super partner, Dusty Rhodes, and we are going to try so hard to defeat all the competition and take a Crockett Cup home with us.
On the first night, the special added match in the cage. Ole Anderson against Big Bubba in Baltimore.
Well, I tell you what, you know, when you get into a cage, you've already got a tough match. Because there's nobody can get in, nobody gets out until the match is over. But in this particular match, there's a little special added significance. Because Bubba on the one side is going to have to go against two people. That's right, two people. I'm talking about Ole Anderson and this Louisville Slugger. They want to make light of it? Well, you go right ahead. You make all the jokes you want. But when I wrap this baseball bat upside your head, it ain't going to be no joke. Bubba, you're big, you're strong, and you got that mealy-mouthed cornet sitting on the outside. But I got the Louisville Slugger. Don't think for a moment I won't use it. I'm going to beat you upside the head, make you bloody, make you look like a raw piece of hamburger. And I'm going to be shoving you right through this cage. In Baltimore.
Okay, this next match will be an Australian tag team match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit featuring Brady Boone and Mitch Snow going up against the Tahitian Prince and Shasta Watley. Right now, I'll tell you, Shasta Watley and the Tahitian Prince are out to prove to many people throughout the country that they are two of the toughest around. And right now, I have been joined by Kevin Sullivan.
And there, a nice go behind by Mitch Snow. Only have, whoa, a standing Grammy executed by the controversial Shasta Watley. He may be controversial, but he certainly has wrestling knowledge and moves.
That's only the second time in my life I've ever seen a standing Grammy roll. The last time I ever saw a standing Grammy roll was back in 1974 in Jack Briscoe and Dirty Fox. I keep these wrestling knowledge stored in the back of my mind in case I ever have to use it. And Buddy Cole, talking about Rollins, you know, I heard you make a comment on the sister show that you said your wife could beat up Sir Oliver Humperdinck, who is the real Florida heavyweight champion. I heard that your wife put a standing Grammy on you and had you down the other day. Is it true you're a battered husband?
Well, you might say anything you like, but I believe it is the fact that I don't think Sir Oliver Humperdinck could stand up to my pretty little 110-pound wife. And I think even myself right now, having wrestled in 10 years, I could beat the man in 1 minute, as anybody could. And for anybody to believe that Sir Oliver Humperdinck was ever the Florida heavyweight champion, I find too ludicrous for even the feeblest of minds to believe anything such as
that. Let me ask you this. How do you think that Shasta Watley learned the standing Granby? Hump has been practicing all week with the charm of standing Granby and a brandy on the rocks. I'm not sure what you showed him.
Well, I will attest to this, too. I do believe that Shasta Watley is no doubt a great wrestler, both in the amateur ranks and the professional ranks. And I also disbelieve the fact that Sir Oliver Humperdinck fought the standing Granby role to Shasta Watley. Shasta Watley is a great wrestler, as is the Tahitian Prince. But no thanks to Sir Oliver Humperdinck.
Maybe it was an egg roll he caught or something. I'm not exactly sure of this. You see, this Brady Boone impresses me, and I'm not impressed much. But he's against one of the most awesome individuals, the Tahitian Prince. This big man can do anything. He moves like a cat. Coach, he must be 6'4", would you say? He's got a head as hard as a coconut. He must be 280 pounds. And he moves like a giant cat.
Well, Coach Heath, let me ask you this. Now, you've been a wrestling coach for more years than I care to remember. You see many of these great wrestling moves. Do you believe that Sir Oliver Humperdinck is a wrestling trainer rather than just a mentor?
I don't think that he just showed Joshua Watley that standing reverse gut wrench move that he applied on Brady Boone. I believe that Humperdinck would be very good.
You're absolutely right. Humperdinck did show him that standing gut wrench. Coach, are you the coach is on my side. He knows that Humperdinck did teach him that standing gut wrench.
Just a moment, Mr. Sullivan. I believe you interrupted the coach before he was finished.
Well, the coach was finished before he started today.
I think that,
by the way, Coach, what was that strange bottle of your bag this afternoon?
I think that Humperdinck would be great at showing pinning combinations.